This time on More with the Mayor, we're going to be getting artsy. This historic home doubles as a premier art gallery. We'll take you inside. Plus, learn about an art exhibit so big it completely takes over downtown. Then the future of public art. A new commission is being drawn up. We'll have the details. And Viva Nash Vegas, a popular radio show that's as fun as it sounds. See how they shine a spotlight on local musicians every other weekend. All of this and more, this time on More with the Mayor. Everyone, welcome to More with the Mayor. We've got a big show for you today, and we're focusing on art and the artists who give Franklin so much color. Let's get the 411 on Gallery 202. With me now is Kelly Harwood, who's the proprietor of Gallery 202 and also an artist himself, and just wanted to come by and look at some of the artwork and talk about some of the things that happened at Gallery 202 here on the corner of 2nd and Church.
Well, welcome.
Thank you.
Glad to have you here. So I'll share a little bit about Gallery 202. We're located in a historic home called Clouston Hall. It was built in 1821, and we're very proud of our artists. We have mostly local artists here, and I'd like to share a couple of artists' pieces. This is Emily Allison. She does found objects, like this chair leg here, paper mache, and she hand creates all of her pieces. There's several throughout the gallery that I'll be happy to show you. This is Michael Hooper's work. He's more of a folk artist, and he does some really large pieces and does a lot of smaller pieces on found boards. Self-taught artist also. So then stepping into this room, we're very proud of Emily's work. Like I just mentioned, her piece in the foyer. This is an ad that was in the Nashville Arts Magazine. So this piece sold, and we've sold about 10 since she's had her show. She's the featured artist this month. So this is one of her other pieces. They also move a little bit. And Ken, I think you and Linda have one of these pieces here from Emily's.
It's like we do. We do. Linda spotted these one day when she was over here, and she brought me over and convinced me that we needed one. And so it's got a very special spot in our house, and in fact, you helped us.
I did, hung it in the top stairwell of
the room. So, I mean, once you walk in the front door, you get a great visual of it.
She greets you, doesn't she?
Yeah, absolutely. So what else you got?
Well, this is some interesting work here, Melvin Toledo, and he has done more of a photorealism type of art. And it's some of it is so realistic, you looks like you could pick something up in it.
Exactly.
This is over the fireplace here is Tiffany Foss. She does plein air work, local artist also here in Franklin, Tennessee. And then we'll step right through here. As you can see, some of the architect of the building here, this is almost 15-foot ceilings. And this house is built
great doors, huh?
Oh, they're wonderful. Yeah. And they swing open. They're not pocket doors, but they swing open.
Yeah.
And so this room has Julie Harvey's work in it. She's a local artist here. She just lives a few streets away. And she does abstracts, and she's been in the gallery since day one. Really proud of her. And I guess you can't help but notice this large piece here.
Oh, tell me about this. This looks like something really local.
It is
really
so local that all the community painted it. So it's a paint by number. And Michael D'Amico had this printed up. As if you look close, you can see the numbers through there. And it's still almost finished. A few more brush strokes and it'll be finished. And so the community painted on it during the Franklin art scene one night, and it was a public event. And it's just a beautiful piece, and it's really big. So just a few more little touches here, and it's gonna be finished up. As you can see, we do sell antique furniture. My friend Jim McReynolds, the gallery manager, hand selects every piece that we get. We have everything from sugar chests to beautiful other pieces of furniture.
I love some of the turn pieces.
Yeah, they're gorgeous.
Yeah.
This is Ken Gaddis. As you can see, this is a beautiful piece of wood here. Ken Gaddis is a Siberian elm burl here, and it's just hand turned, nice heavy piece.
And that the uglier the wood, the more they like it.
The gnarly knots and everything that you see there.
Yeah. Good.
All right, and then around the corner here, I think you've seen this before, Ken, I'm not sure, but this is a cannonball burn from the Civil War. Remember, this house is pre-Civil War, 1821. So this is where a 3-pound cannonball came through. I actually keep it in this drawer here.
Well, you know me, I love finding out about the history of Franklin, so tell me more.
So this is not the cannonball, but one like it. Rick Warwick, I think, is the one that dropped this off to us. So this came through the roof during the Battle of Franklin, and it hit here, rolled, and it scarred the floor there with a burn. So we share this with a lot of visitors that come to Franklin. Margie Thessen, who does Franklin on Foot, comes through practically daily, and we share a lot of the history of the gallery and the Clouston Hall and the Battle of Franklin being the Civil War. There's blood stains in the front room where they used it as surgery. And I think you can tell that there's two buckets that overflowed with blood, stained the floor, and it's right in the front window, and that's where the good light would come through for the surgeon to do the surgeries.
And the Battle of Franklin, the population of Franklin was really pretty small, but the number of people that were killed was very great. And so pretty much every home was turned into a hospital.
Exactly.
Not only for Union soldiers, but for Confederate soldiers, and people of the town came together and took care of the wounded, injury, and the dead, and buried many of them.
I always add, a lot of lives were saved in that room where the bloodstains are, to try to think of a positive thing about it because it was so gruesome. But so, even though all the blood on the floor there, they fought to save lives, which is important.
Well, Kelly, thanks so much for giving us a tour of the gallery, this historic building, and how you've preserved it so well, and also the beautiful artwork. But do we really have an art scene in Franklin?
Oh, yes. It's a big art scene. It's called the Franklin Art Scene. Yeah, a lot of people call it the art crawl. But the gallery here, you can pick up a trolley in front and ride around for free around town and jump off at different locations. And there's wonderful galleries around town. There's different businesses that'll host an artist. So you never know what you're gonna find, because Franklin is full of fantastic artists here. And they get to show at different locations, and you just come home with something great and wonderful every time.
And I had the opportunity recently to be on the art scene, or the art crawl, as many people call it. And so we're gonna take a look at that.
The art crawl is super important. I think it brings fine art to the face of downtown. It gets people that aren't as familiar with fine art, or you know, haven't been to galleries, a chance to come in, see some artwork. You're not pressured into buying anything, you can have a fun experience.
Well, we are going into our sixth year, and it was started because so many artists wanted the opportunity to show their art, and there was only one gallery. So Kelly Harwood and Michael D'Amico got together and started the art crawl. Our goal is to give artists the opportunity to show their work when they otherwise would not, and to bring people into downtown Franklin on a Friday night and to just provide a great sense of community.
I'd say it allows you to introduce your art to different communities and people that aren't usually going to see it in other places. So that helps out tremendously. And I mean, it's always good to talk to different people and get the views and get the feedback from, you know, how people in different communities and different areas view it.
I love being a part of the Art Crawl. I love to walk downtown on Friday night during the First Friday, and I love to meet the artists, and they get so excited. Sometimes it's the first time they've sold a piece of art. It's just a really great, positive feeling to be involved and to have that happen in our town.
When we come back, Art for the People, a look at the future of public art in Franklin. Then later,
turn your radio on.
Local musicians making waves. Stay with us.
Good morning, Franklin. It's another beautiful day in the neighborhood. Local news is coming up next. We'll check the weather and the traffic. You have a great day.
Welcome back. Recently, I signed an ordinance that brings a public arts commission to Franklin. I sat down with two business leaders who are spearheading this effort with a blank canvas. We're glad to have a couple of special guests today to talk about a new ordinance in the city of Franklin. And with us are Ellie Westman Chen from our Williamson County Visitors Convention Bureau and Julie Walton Garland from Walton's Jewelry. So welcome.
Thank you.
So recently our board passed an ordinance establishing an arts commission. So, you know, we're a Civil War town. Why are we creating an arts commission? What's the deal?
Yeah, so in the last couple of years, we've really seen an interest from residents and visitors in public art in Franklin. It's a great way for people to engage with our community, people that live here, people that are visiting. It's a great thing to have across the country. We've studied different cities that have a public art program. So it's something that we feel that Franklin really needs and really wants. And Ellie from the Visitors Bureau can kind of give us these numbers as to why it's important for tourism as well.
The cultural traveler is a very important traveler. What we find is that when they come into town, they spend about 60% more on their trip than a regular domestic traveler. So we're excited about that and giving them an opportunity to come into Franklin and Williamson County for a different reason than our music and our history and so forth. Also, what we find is that right now the cultural traveler is an affluent baby boomer, but 73% of millennials are now traveling to engage in a community's art and culture. So that's an important visitor for us as well.
Great. So how are we going to pay for it?
Well, the public art ordinance that we've created.
Yeah, how are you going to pay for it?
That's an important question.
Yes.
There's actually a ton of grants that are out there for cities to apply for. We've actually already been approached by quite a few people that want to give us this money. They want to give us these grants because they think Franklin Public Art is so important. So grants are a huge one. Different organizations and different individuals, different artists. There's a lot of different ways that funds will be created. It's not through tax dollars or from the city. This is something it's a side income.
How do you create that enthusiasm? What are your selling points to get people to buy in to give money for an art commission for public art?
Public art has shown to be a really successful endeavor for lots of cities across the country, big and small, so Franklin definitely fits in there. Public art creates more of a community experience. It engages people that are within the community. And for businesses succeed in a community that's very engaged. So I think that's a huge proponent for public art.
If you don't mind me adding a few things.
Sure.
Great. One, I think it creates a sense of a welcoming atmosphere for visitors and residents. And big bonus is it's free. So you can walk around and view public art. You could go by yourself. You could go with a group. And it's just a way to get people out around our community.
So have you started identifying some spots where art might go?
We haven't yet. Because we just got it passed through the board, mm-hmm. and our next step will be creating the commission. And once that's created, then I think we can take a look at sites. I think what's important for everyone to remember is that this is all of Franklin. So if someone comes to us and says, I've got a neat idea for Cool Springs, great, let's talk about that. Or if somebody says, I have an idea for downtown Franklin, wonderful, let's talk about that as well. If it's gonna be in the historic district, then we'll include historic zoning in those conversations because we wanna make sure that it continues to align with the historic district and what we've created here. So I think anywhere in Franklin is an opportunity.
So this arts commission that you mentioned, who's gonna be on it? How do you pick who's gonna be on this commission?
So there's 9 members. And all those members, one of them will be a board of mayor and alderman member, so an alderman. And then the rest of them are going to be people that live within Williamson County that have some sort of arts background and education. So that could be anywhere from people that are involved in different art organizations in the county, art instructors at different schools, art gallery owners, artists themselves. So a variety of different places, but we do want to incorporate an arts background.
So what's your vision? What might be the first project?
We have a lot of ideas because yeah, we're excited. You know, we've heard from a lot of different people on what they think it should be. And we've heard everything from a freestanding statue to murals to a fountain or a landscape architecture. So I think it'll be interesting once we actually launch the commission and make it public and let people know that they can submit an application for artwork, what we see and what that passion is. So we're excited to learn about that.
Definitely. So if someone has a great idea, how do they pass that idea along? Do they go to Julie, they go to Ellie, or do they just wait until the commission's formed and go to the commission? What's the best way?
We're always happy to chat with anybody.
Yes, we are.
So we're happy to point people in the right direction. Since the ordinance has passed, the best thing to do would be also to contact the city so you can get a copy of the ordinance and read it, educate yourself. It shows the application process. It outlines all of that there. So if somebody did want to submit an application, all the guidelines are there. And then if something still wasn't clear, or somebody had questions, they're welcome to reach out to one of us.
And my email is easily obtained, so people are welcome to send some kind of note or letter of interest or suggestion. I'm always glad to accept those and pass them on.
Wonderful.
Well, great. Thanks for being here, and what an exciting time for the city of Franklin. I can't wait to see what you come up with, and so we'll be back in just a few moments. Coming up, we're dialing in on Viva Nash Vegas, an artsy radio show broadcasted from one of the hippest places in town. Stay with us.
911, what's the address of your emergency?
Well, it's not really an emergency, it's loud music.
Okay, hold just one moment. I'm going to try to switch a non-emergency number, okay, so we don't top a 911 line.
When it's not a life or death emergency, dial 794-2513. Yeah, 794-2513. My neighbor's music's too loud, you see. Dial 794-2513. 794-2513. That's 794-2513. Thank you. I dial 794-2513, and the Franklin police, they answered me. 794-2513. 794-2513. When it's not a life or death emergency, dial 794-2513. That's 794-2513.
What's the location of the emergency?
There's not an emergency. I need the non-emergency number.
Welcome back to More with the Mayor. Every other Saturday morning, Kimbrough's Picking Parlor plays host to a fun radio show called Viva Nash Vegas. This program introduces local musicians to an international audience. Our cameras were inside, and here's what they captured.
I played on the Grand Ole Opry with my father, George Hamilton IV, for 30 years. And I just wanted to bring a bit of Nashville out here to Franklin, something to represent the variety of music that would be on the Grand Ole Opry. And much of it, it would be the older style of music you would hear on the Opry, because we live in a very modern age with great modern sounds, but Americana has put a focus on the roots. Kimbrough's has always been our favorite music venue in Franklin. Well, I love it because it kind of looks like the Green Acres House or something. It looks like farm in downtown Franklin. And they have just a very eclectic audience that comes here. And so Will came up to us one day when we realized we needed to move venues to a larger space or something that had food options. And we started out in Handy Hardware, and Will said, hey, we want to have y'all down at Kimbrough. It just sort of represents life here in Franklin with a little bit of Wayne's World meets Hee Haw. I think it's very exciting, very important. We have people who watch us all over the world. And so Franklin, I like to believe, is the new Music City. The whole thing may be what Franklin could have been many years ago with a real twist. So it takes people on this journey. It's like a mythical type place, kind of like Prairie Home Companion, but right here in beautiful downtown Franklin. It kind of represents the spirit of Franklin, because really it is a friendly town. And it's like an open stage where it's like, wow, man, this isn't just country music. This isn't just whatever it is. I mean, it's like everybody's here. So it's a real party.
Before we go, I wanted to show you something the city has been doing to celebrate local artists. This wall space in City Hall is called the Fire Hall Art Gallery. The hall along that south side entrance has been hosting exhibits from different Franklin and Williamson County artists since 2007. Exhibits and artists are circulated through the hall several times a year. Our latest exhibit features work from this year's Kids Art Festival, where hundreds of students, kindergarten through 12th grade, submitted original artwork. We sure do have some wonderful young artists in Franklin, and we're proud to showcase them all in City Hall. Well, that does it for this episode of More with the Mayor. Thanks so much for watching. We'll see you next time.